What a life Travis Crawford had.
I'm gonna take another chance card.
Bye.
Watching his little one grow up and making the most of the outdoors with his girlfriend and family.
Hi.
He liked his job too as a sheriff's deputy in Mesa County, where he frequently trained for his job in the jail. In June 2021, he got COVID.
It was scary because he kept coughing really hard.
See someone you love unconscious on a breathing machine. I think that was probably the scariest moment of my life.
I take buspirone to help with anxiety and mood stabilization, fluoxetine. I've been on Cymbalta, I've been on Zoloft. I have problems with incontinence, so I take that every day. I take a steroid inhaler, Advair, every day. I take air to mist my nostrils so that I get less bloody noses. Prazosin, mirtazapine, mirabetric.
Crawford says he was on a ventilator and had to be flown to the Denver area where he nearly died. Before he went in, a friend promised to care for his son, Arden, if he didn't survive.
He would make sure that my son knew who I was, and that he would move wherever Arden ended up and make sure he was taken care of. And that was a kind of a peaceful feeling to have.
Crawford says he spent nearly 3 months in the hospital, and while he was fighting for his life, the sheriff's office terminated him because he was unable to return and work the essential functions of the deputy sheriff position.
I certainly could not have fought with an inmate. I certainly could not have wrestled with somebody or tried to gain arrest control or done a defensive tactics takedown on someone. Not now. They let me keep my badge. They told me that I was a member of their family. They said that they weren't doing this willingly.
He applied for workers' compensation, saying he contracted COVID-19 at the jail. He argued he had been in direct contact with inmates and coworkers who were sick with COVID-19. And the state health department documented an outbreak at the sheriff's office around the time Crawford got sick. But Crawford also attended his grandfather's funeral in that time frame, raising questions about the possibility of other exposure. And the company responsible for approving his claim, TriStar Risk Management, would not grant the benefit. They also declined an interview.
They are sitting there making it so that I don't get benefits. Everyone that works there knows that I got it there.
The burden is always on the injured worker to show that the disease or the injury occurred within the course and scope of their employment.
Paul Torriello is the director of Colorado's Division of Workers' Compensation and says proving someone got an illness at work is much more difficult than proving an injury like breaking an arm after falling off a machine.
Early in the pandemic, that was a lot easier because it was not what we call community spread.
Torriello says more than 12,000 people filed COVID-related claims in Colorado between March 2020 and April 2022, and workers' comp insurers denied approximately 72% of them. That's more than 8,600 cases, including claims for 39 people who died.
The denial rate has actually gone up over time, and we believe that this is a direct correlation with the fact that the disease has spread that much further in the community outside of people's workplaces, therefore making it that much harder to prove that it was a work-related exposure.
Crawford says he believes the chemical munitions training weeks before his diagnosis weakened his lungs, making them more susceptible to getting sick. And then he learned of this letter signed by the undersheriff. It includes an analysis of Crawford's illness to see if he could qualify for a federal public safety officer's benefit program, which presumes any first responders' COVID-19 complications occurred in the line of duty if they meet certain criteria. This letter says Crawford's COVID-19 diagnosis came 3 days after his last line of duty shift and that it fits all of the criteria to be considered a disability that occurred in the line of duty.
I'm depressed and I'm going through therapy trying to manage and mitigate all that. But I have to pay for therapy out of pocket. I have to do all this stuff on my own.
The fight now is one step at a time. But for Crawford, each literal step he takes just causes more pain.
Crawford filed a lawsuit against TriStar. That company again declined an interview with us, saying privacy laws and policies prevent the company from even acknowledging that a claim had been filed. I'm Lori Jane Gliha, Fox 31.